Yo, what's going on, snipers, and welcome to my NHL 20 beta thoughts. So I'm going to give you guys a couple of my thoughts about the beta so far. I've only played it obviously for like a couple days, I guess, since it's been out since Friday at like noon. So anyways, let's get into my thoughts. So the first thing I like about this game is, well, I like going into the UI, especially like the interface of the game. Because if you guys didn't know, I actually go to school to study that type of thing, so I really like looking at the UI of the game, and from what I see, it looks very good. It's pretty much the exact same thing, almost like the main menu in a sense, is NHL 19's is. The color scheme looks a lot different, but it looks really good, like the blue and orange contrast, it's really nice. And then also the font use, I think the font might be actually really similar to the one like the base font, to the one that they used like in old gen NHL, if I'm not mistaken, like in franchise mode and stuff like that. They used to have like this one font. I think it's a pretty similar font. And then the other font that they use in this game, like on screens on ESHL and all that, it looks really good. I really like how it looks. So in terms of gameplay, now starting off with the menu, I do think the menu has a very good speed right now, but then again, it's not the full game, so when the full game comes out, it could slow down a bit. But right now, it seems like the speed of the game is a lot faster. It could be just me personally. Now, from actual gameplay standards, there's a few things that I would fix if I was EA, and that is that AI skaters seem to skate right into goalies a lot, especially on penalty shots. I've at least witnessed it twice in the like 20 games I've played, where like a AI guy gets a penalty shot, he skates right into the goaltender and doesn't even get a shot on the penalty shot. Another thing I would fix is the goalies are having a bit of difficulty stopping the puck, because like I was watching Toogie stream two nights ago, I think it was, and like a shot went right through his arm, and or maybe it was right through his body, but it went right through him and into the net. So they need to kind of tweak stuff with that with the goaltenders, at least for manual users, because it's going to get frustrating if you're a goalie all year round for an ESHL club or something. One thing I really like so far is the new shot animations. I just find they look really nice and clean, especially like the one where you could just like spin around and shoot. I posted a video of that on my Twitter account. I just really like how it looks good, and it feels good too when you make those shots. And it looks a lot more realistic too. Another thing I think they need to fix with goaltenders is it seems like when a player skates into a goalie and bumps them, they go actually right inside the net and then they can't get out of the net. So like it's when there's a stoppage of play, I've witnessed that also a couple times where like a player gets bumped into the goalie and he gets pushed into the net and then he's like trapped in the net for a second and then he gets his way out. I don't know if that's any way EA could fix that or what, but at least maybe have them not slide right into the net, because it's kind of weird. Like, I know it's kind of realistic in a sense that they get slid right into the net, but then they just, like, get glitched into the net somewhat, so. Another thing I would fix is also, it seems like AI players, aren't 100% smart yet. Like, they don't go through the puck on, like if they go for the puck, kind of, they're going for a puck when you're going for a puck, so then if you're on the same team, you have two players converging on one puck in ESHL, and then it leads on to a 2-on-1 breakaway the other way, so it's kind of annoying in that sense, but I think it doesn't happen all the time, so. And it could have been also fixed, because this build is 8 weeks behind what they're currently on, so I don't know if they've fixed any of these things. I saw there was a giant list. I kind of skimmed through it, so they did fix a lot of things since this build. I don't know if they've also tweaked this, but I think poke checks could be fixed a bit, because poke checks also are resulting in too many tripping calls. It could be just that I'm a really bad online player, which I admit I really am, but like there is a lot of tripping calls. Like I was playing against a guy and he took maybe about, I'd say like 5 tripping penalties in 5 minutes almost of gameplay. So yeah, it might need to be fixed a bit. I think it was like the same thing as an NHL 19's beta. So I'm kind of crossing my fingers that it's going to be fixed or kind of at least tweaked a bit for the actual release. Now this is kind of an extra that I really want them to like kind of adjust in the game is, you know how there's the text-to-speech thing when you first get into the game where it's like naming all this stuff out loud just for those people who aren't very visual capable? It's kind of cool because I think they should at least do this. They should do text-to-speech in terms of like the last name, like the player play-by-play names, because if it like I've been mentioning this for like a couple years, how like there should be at least a way to preview the last names and how they're pronounced. Like at least put a text-to-speech so on that menu, so when you're going over like say Waugh and Roy, you get to know which one's which, because some players might want to have their last name pronounced as Waugh because they're French, and then they choose Roy by mistake or vice versa, you know. So I think they need to at least do something like that where there's like a preview button so you could actually preview the last names. I don't know if they'll be able to do that already for NHL 20, probably not, but at least down the road I think they need to do that, because there's a lot of people that have accessibility problems, and being able to at least hear what the name sounds like, it's better for that type of thing. I used to have that, I think, way back in like NHL 07, so shouldn't be too hard to implement, but I don't know really much about coding that well, so yeah, anyways. Now into the stuff I really liked in this beta. So the first thing, well actually I liked the shot animations like I was mentioning earlier, but there's other things I really liked about the gameplay and stuff like that, which is the commentary and presentation aspect. So the new replays are kind of awesome, because like there's like replays where it kind of slows down and shows a player scoring. I really like those, and it's actually fun to watch the replays and whatnot, so yeah, that thing's pretty sick. The new commentary between James Cebulski and Ray Ferraro is actually pretty good. Now, I know I might get a lot of hate for saying that, but, like, the thing is, you don't want to hear Doc and Eddie, like, saying geometrically and going to get some ice cream and all that stuff over and over and over again. We've been hearing that stuff for the last 4 years. So I think they made a good decision in changing the commentary duo and getting rid of that NBC license, because it was getting pretty boring and whatnot. And besides, like they were saying, James Cebulski and Ray Ferraro, they're both BC guys, so they're going to be in the studio a lot more often, which means they could record stuff throughout the season, so you're going to get a lot better commentary in that sense. Now, I know James Cebulski sounds a little weird when he talks, like when he's like screaming about a play, but he's got a lot more emotion than someone like Doc, I find, because like Doc is just like, geometrically, you know, it's just like, no. It's not even really like commentary at that point. Like, he's saying the puck passing and all that stuff, but geometrically and Lady from Shawinigan, that type of thing, it's like, that stuff was not realistic. And if you guys are saying James Cebulski's commentary is unrealistic, but the thing is, I think I heard that he's just getting into play-by-play, so give him some time, he'll grow as a play-by-play guy, and I think he'll do a good job. Another thing I really find sick is the play of the period thing in ESHL. That's actually a lot of fun seeing that, because right at the end of the period, you just see that nice like play of the period where it shows your player if you scored the goal or if you made a big save or whatnot, and then it shows the replay of it in slow motion, and then the camera angle on that is pretty cool too, because it almost looks like it's on like a dolly kind of system, and it just like spins around the entire like arena, and it's really neat. I really like it. It's really like dynamic, I guess you could say. And the final thing, I actually really do like the scoreboard on the bottom. Like, I don't find it makes much of a difference than it was on the top. But I think it is a good thing, because you can see all the way up the ice a lot better, and that's good for those online players or those guys that get into competitive, like, leagues and stuff like that. I think it's really good for the game. Personally, I don't play a lot of games because I'm a franchise mode kind of guy, but I think it's a good acquisition for the game. I know a lot of people have been complaining about it and whatnot. What I would do if I was EA is if they kind of made a way to have a scoreboard on the top, not the exact same scoreboard, because the scoreboard, like if you put the current scoreboard on the top, I saw like SB Visuals or something like that, I think his name is, or Tyler, I think his name is. I think I saw like a part where he put the thing on the top and it just did not look good at all. It kind of is like too dense up there. So what I would do is, like, I don't think they could do this for 20, but I would give the option for like the player to put the scoreboard wherever they want, so on the top or the bottom, and then maybe if it's on the top, kind of adjust to the size of it so it's not as like dominant on the person's view. So at least that's my thoughts. So anyways, guys, that's my thoughts here on the NHL 20 beta. I want to know what you guys think about it down below as well, because if you guys post any like valuable comments, I might compile this into a bit of a, like a list and then maybe send it to EA, because I do have DMs open to them, because they actually followed me. If you are new around here, I actually got followed by them on Twitter back in October because of a NHL 19 video, so I'm able to send them messages, but I'm not going to be just consistently repeating the same thing that everybody says, which is GM connected and roster sharing and stuff like that. I know that stuff would make the game a lot cooler and whatnot, but this is just full out gameplay and like NHL 20 beta comments. The other stuff we could hope for hopefully like NHL 21 or 22 or down the road, but yeah, just keep it kind of civil if you are going to comment stuff. Don't just like freak out about certain things not being in the game, because I know how hard it is, because like I really want roster sharing. If you guys haven't seen any of my older videos, I've made a ton of good roster like builds and stuff like that, so I'm like one of these people like 2E that are up there in terms of wanting roster sharing in the game. So I'm still holding my breath that they actually have it for NHL 20, because they have not announced anything on like the franchise front and all that stuff, but hopefully they do soon, because I'm really interested to see how it looks this coming year. So anyways, let me know what you guys think, and I'll see you guys next time.